For those of you who don't know what Playmaker is, Playmaker is an extension to Unity Editor created by a company called Hutong. Playmaker basically adds FSM, or finite state machine functionality, to game object in Unity. I will not cover the detail too much in this tutorial about what is FSM and how to use Playmaker from scratch, because you can find very clear and complete tutorials about Playmaker FSM in Hutong's website. Okay, so to add a new FSM, open the Playmaker editor and just right-click and then choose Add FSM. Notice by doing this, a Playmaker component is added to the object. So if later you want to remove the FSM, simply click this option panel and choose Remove Component. Okay, now the first state, or the state that has the start event on it, we want to rename this state to closed, because at first the chest should be in closed condition. And then right click, add another state and name it opening. Then another state called opened. And the last state will be closing state. Okay, now that our states are all defined, we need to create an event. Event in programming terms are something that is happening and that we want to inform other object or objects about it. In Playmaker, an event is symbolized as arrows. So basically, if you want to create an arrow or transition, then you need to create an event. Okay, so in the event tab, we can create a new event by typing clicked and then just hit enter. You can name event to any name you want as long as it makes sense to you, and so you or your team will understand it. We name our event clicked for any transition between state that happens due to the user's mouse click. So to use the event, we can right click on the closed state and then add transition. Notice the clicked event that we created before is nicely listed in here by Playmaker. Drag this event so it creates an arrow to the opening state. In the opening state, we're going to play the opening animation. Then, after it is finished, it should automatically transitioning to the opened state. Now, for the finish event, we actually don't need to create it ourselves, as Playmaker already has one called finished, with all capital letter. Next, from opened state to closing state, we can use the clicked event again. And from closing animation state to closed state, we can use finished event like before. So again, when the game starts, the object will be in closed state. Then when the user clicks the object, it should go to the opening state, which plays the animation. Then after the animation finished playing, it will jump to the opened state. Then when in open state, the user click on it, it will go to the closing animation state. And after the animation is finished, it will go back to the closed state. Okay, currently our FSM will do nothing as we don't have any actions inside each of the state. To add an action, let's pick the closed state first. Then in the state tab, down here, we can see the action browser button. Click it and then type pick. You will see mouse pick event action listed. We can double click on it. Now the mouse pick event action is added to the closed state. The game object option up here determine which object will be the target. Use owner means that it will target itself to check whether it is being clicked or not. Now this is possible because we have a collider component up here. If no collider exists in this object, Playmaker will display a red error message. Okay, now mouse pick event action can actually pick a lot of mouse events, not just mouse clicking event. But right now, we are only interested in clicking event. For clicking, we can actually use mouse down or mouse up events. Let's choose mouse down event for now. Click on this pull down list and choose clicked, which is the name of our existing event. So basically, when the mouse is down on this object, then the clicked event will fire off, and it will transition the FSM to the next state, which is the opening state. In the opening state, we want to have play animation action. So click on the action browser and then type play. Double click on this play animation action. Okay, the game object is the target object, just as we mentioned before. We can use specify game object if we want to play the animation on other object. Use owner means that the object who owns the Playmaker FSM, which is this object itself. Okay, now on the anim name option, if we click on this list, we can see Playmaker cleverly lists all of the available animations that this object has. Choose opening now. Okay, now let's test it. Click the play game button up here. Sorry, we need to turn off this maximize on play toggle button up here, so we can see the Playmaker editor while the game is running. Let's hit play again. Now, as we can see, as soon as the game play, the closed state will become active. And currently, it is waiting for the mouse key down event. If we click on it, it will fire up the clicked event and move the FSM to the opening state where the opening animation takes place. After finish playing the animation, it will automatically transition to the opened state. From this opened state, we cannot go any further as we haven't created any actions for it. But the process is similar, so let's turn off play for now. Pick this state, then click in here to select the action. Press Ctrl C to copy. Then pick this state, click in here, and then Ctrl V to paste the action. Okay, now of course for this state, it should play the closing animation. Next, let's pick this state, click in here, and press Ctrl C. Then click this state, click in here, and paste it in. For this action, we actually don't need to change anything. Okay, so that's it. Let's do a final test. Let's make it maximize for now. Hit play again. Click to open and then click to close. Okay guys, as always, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Give a thumbs up if you like the video and give a thumbs down if you don't like the video. See you in my other tutorials. Wassalamualaikum.